and the states have settled on the solution to our problems is we haven't been evaluating teachers. And that is not the root cause of our problems. The root cause of our problems is that almost 1 out of 4 children live in poverty.
Influence in education.
Well, I can't help but he'll meet with me. buying lots of expensive television ads, flooding everybody's mailboxes, you know, you can't have a decent democratic society. So that's not what Gates Foundation is doing, obviously, but we just had, there was just recently an election in Denver where one side got overwhelming money, the other side didn't. There was just a state board election in Louisiana where a lot of out-of-state money came in to elect Bobby Jindal's candidates. And the governor of Louisiana is supposed to have 3 seats on the board, but he wants to get control of the whole board so that he can have vouchers and privatization and all the things he believes in. And I don't know how people of Louisiana get informed. There's a problem. There's a problem about not having adequate access to the media. And about the, I mean, I think the wonderful thing for me about the CNN show, which by the way I didn't watch, because I can't stand watching myself on television, but it happens so seldom it's not a big problem. But the great thing about that program was I got on it at all, so there was some semblance of balance. Because normally when you have documentaries about education, it's all the, you know, gloom and doom, what I call the bad news industry. And when the NAEP scores came out recently, the NAEP scores should have been seen as, gosh, well, 10 years of NCLB and nothing much is changing. But instead, all the people who want more privatization were saying, see, our schools are still failing. It's like looking into a witch's mirror and seeing what you want to see. But I do think there's a problem in our democracy when the money becomes so powerful that people don't even understand what the issues are.
Yeah.
That may be one of the reasons why we're losing the teaching of civics. Children need to understand. They need to understand how to find information beyond what's available to them on the major networks. Yes, sir.
My name is Dan, and I am a teacher at SCORE. I think Gates might get the idea if we go down and do a greeting on his Gates Foundation front steps. Maybe he'll see all the work that we do after hours. He might get a little bit of an idea of the kind of challenges we face. I have a question and a short comment for you. One, I was hoping that you could comment a little bit more about the intersection of the emerging Occupy movement with opposition to corporate education reform. And the reason I ask you that is because I have a slight disagreement with some of the things you said, which is that, one of the things you said, which is that the corporate ed reformers have the money. They have connections. They even have their key allies in both parties. What they don't have is all the power. And I think that the Occupy movement has shown that we have the numbers. You know, we can turn the tides on this. 99-1, they don't stand a chance.
One of the leaders of the Occupy movement in New York City is a teacher. So they are very much attuned to education issues. And they, in New York City, there's a lot to complain about because we have mayoral control. We have a puppet board, and the mayor controls the majority, and they always vote whatever the mayor wants. And there is no democracy. There's also no accountability. So there's a lot of reasons for the Occupy movement to turn to education, and I believe that they are and they will. And there was just recently a meeting of, we call our Board of Education, Program on Education, no, I don't know, PEP stands for something, nobody knows what it is. But it was a way of making it seem less important. It's not the Board of Education. So when they held the meeting, the Occupy people came in, 200 of them, and they did their human mic check. And they completely stopped the meeting. They had the power, 200 people, to stop any meeting they want to stop. So this can be kind of scary in a way because democracy doesn't work by people drowning others out. When you have no democracy, you have to be heard.
I just want to give about 5 minutes left for questions, so if we don't wait, we can get to the last few. Thanks.
Hello, I am a public worker, union member, and I teach the kids that you're talking about that are not being served. And I had a young man here, and the reason why I brought him was because he told me straight up, if you take away schools, you will take away my life. This is affecting students from every district, this group. Students are failing because they don't have the help and the discipline they need. If we close schools, where are our futures going to be? For me, school has helped me stay out of trouble from the streets and the gangs. I'm inspired by school to change my life. He's probably the oldest person in the room, huh?
Thank you very much.